I think it's possible to brainwash, manipulate, coerce people to do just about anything.
Healthy religion preserves a person's sense of free will, whereas destructive mind control cults do not want people to think for themselves.
Under the right circumstances, most people can have their views manipulated and altered.
A mente humana, a ferramenta mais poderosa à face da Terra. A sua capacidade para criar ou destruir é ilimitada. A habilidade de controlar ou influenciar a mente humana é poder supremo, o poder de manipular, subjugar e dominar. É a história arrepiante da batalha pelo controle das mentes humanas, uma guerra de ideologias pelo domínio do mundo. A batalha pelo controle mental é realizada usando sexo, espiões e drogas psicadélicas.
White would watch behind two-way mirrors while these prostitutes whom he was working with would slip drugs, including LSD, into the drinks of these people who thought they were just there to have a night of pleasure.
É a história verídica e poderosa de uma conspiração da CIA envolvendo operativos a soldo, encobrimentos burocráticos e psiquiátricos sádicos.
What Cameron was doing was well beyond an experimental treatment. It was in the realm of science fiction.
O projeto contém experiências horripilantes que deixaram centenas de pessoas marcadas para a vida.
I received a total of 109 electroconvulsive shock treatments. I had 86 straight comatose days.
Esta procura incessante por armas psicológicas alastrou-se a todo o mundo, deixando um rastro de mortes misteriosas.
These people were not sentimental about human life, and they certainly believed that everything they were doing was in the interest of maintaining the freedom of the Western world.
No fim, produziu um legado de controle mental que chegaria ao novo milénio.
If you don't take responsibility for what goes into your mind, somebody else will.
The greatest battle of the 21st century will be a battle of the mind.
Controlar as mentes. 26 de março de 1997, Rancho Santa Fé, na Califórnia. A descoberta horrenda de 39 corpos numa mansão de $1 milhão chocou o mundo. Mais chocante ainda é o motivo para o que aconteceu. Através da brilhante manipulação de um homem, 38 pessoas acordaram em tomar fenobarbital e asfixiarem-se de forma a chegarem a uma nave espacial que seguia atrás de um cometa. Foi o maior suicídio em massa em solo americano. Foi também o último exemplo de uma guerra vivida em todo o mundo pelo controle das mentes humanas. Uma guerra moderna pelo controle mental, na qual a manipulação das armas tinha se tornado tão refinada que até o mais são dos indivíduos poderia ser convencido a fazer qualquer coisa. Uma guerra moderna pelo controle mental, cujo desenvolvimento de armas foi registado há quase meio século atrás, na outra metade do mundo. Esta é a história arrepiante de como se iniciou a batalha pela mente humana, com uma série de eventos horríveis que alimentaram a procura de novas armas que seriam usadas numa guerra ideológica cada vez maior.
The Cold War was the battle for human minds. Really a deadly struggle for ideological supremacy, for the domination of one ideology over the other.
Os comunistas compreendiam o poder da propaganda como instrumento de controle mental e usaram-no de forma brilhante durante o famoso Grande Expurgo de Stalin.
I think we first started to become aware of mind control as a force that could be used by government for political purposes during the 1930s in what were called the Moscow show trials, when a lot of Stalin's old enemies were put on trial and remarkably confessed to crimes they could not have committed.
Os comunistas filmaram as confissões impostas e mostraram depois a todo o mundo a dureza sem piedade do sistema soviético.
The technique was rather simple. People would be beaten. People would be tortured. People would be denied food. They would break down because they would be duped by their interrogators. They would say, listen, if you confess and if you point to others who may have been involved in anti-state activity, then you have a chance to be pardoned. You will not be shot. And some people would believe it, and they would be imprisoned and shot.
And at that point, the Western countries became alarmed that the Soviets had developed techniques to control the way people think and act.
Uma década mais tarde, logo depois da vitória aliada na Segunda Guerra Mundial, os medos do Ocidente regressaram à medida que o sistema comunista soviético avançava imparável pela Europa de Leste. A propaganda soviética teve o pior inimigo na pessoa improvável de um humilde clérigo húngaro, o cardeal Józef Mindenszky. Opositor fervoroso do comunismo, o cardeal tornar-se-ia uma das primeiras vítimas da batalha pelo controle mental travada durante a Guerra Fria.
He was kidnapped literally out of his cathedral. They took the poor man and subjected him to a rather brutal period in which he was stripped of everything, including his clothes. He was cold and miserable and lonely and sleep deprived. Then, a relatively short time later, appeared in a court with the foreign journalists all invited and confessed that he had been an American spy and an enemy of the people and so forth.
Quando o cardeal confessou ser espião, todos acreditaram que uma qualquer droga de controle mental tinha sido usada nele.
At the Vatican, the most solemn procedure of the Catholic Church denounces Hungarian communist treatment of Joseph Cardinal Mindenszky. The Sacred College of Cardinals assembles an extraordinary secret consistory to hear the papal indictment of the mock trial of Cardinal Mindenszky.
The Hungarians used the same old Soviet methods, and the Soviets naturally helped them conduct investigation and interrogation. And I simply know the persuasive power of good investigators.
When he began confessing to crimes he could not have committed, the intelligence agencies and the military agencies began to fear that the Soviets were winning what was called the battle for control of men's minds.
O medo gerado pela confissão do cardeal passou a terror 18 meses mais tarde, quando os soviéticos agarraram a oportunidade de testar as suas técnicas de controle mental em americanos pela primeira vez.
The Korean War, which started, if I recall, on June 25th of 1950, provided the Soviets were a unique opportunity to have direct access to the prisoners of war.
We had no heat. Our summer clothing was very light. It froze every night. I simply didn't sleep at night. They would throw open the door without warning and ask me what I was thinking. And if I said I was thinking about home and my wife and my family, they would call those bad thoughts. I think I was becoming a different person. I looked at my arms. I was losing flesh very rapidly. I couldn't remember what my wife looked like. My wife, my bride of 7 months. I got to the point where if they told me something the night before, and then the next night they would ask me the same question, then I would give them the answer they told me, thinking that this would be the correct answer, but it was not. And little by little, I realized what they wanted me to do every night. They wanted me to come in and say, okay, what is truth tonight? You tell me what truth is now. In other words, to be re-educated is to look to them for the answers. And they said, why don't you ask us, Larry? We'll tell you. So that's what they wanted me to do.
Muitos dos métodos de persuasão dos norte-coreanos tinham vindo da tradição de controle mental soviética, bem como de táticas chinesas de reforma mental. Alguns dos métodos usados eram subtis, outros não.
Anybody under those circumstances might, like Cardinal Mindenszky or any other normal person, come to confess to something he hadn't done.
Foi exatamente o que aconteceu. A máquina militar americana, bem como as pessoas que seguiam os acontecimentos em casa, ficaram estupefactas quando ouviram os seus soldados admitirem o uso de armas biológicas.
Then the only other instruction I received, of course, was the order to carry out my germ warfare mission.
They didn't use germ warfare, they didn't drop these bombs, but they were making this up, who knows, perhaps to keep from being tortured at all or tortured more or perhaps even being shot. You had seen enough summary executions that any time they made a threat, you had to take it seriously.
I know I was wondering myself, why on earth we were using this terrible weapon in Korea, even while the peace talks were going on at Kaesong.
Mais uma vez, os observadores ocidentais temiam que uma arma secreta estivesse a ser usada para obter confissões. Estes possíveis cenários foram crescendo até chegar à paranoia, quando uma nova palavra entrou no nosso vocabulário.
Edward Hunter was the man who coined the term brainwashing, and he was a propagandist for the OSS, the predecessor organization to the Central Intelligence Agency.
When my son asked me what I did in Korea, how can I tell him that I came over here and dropped germ bombs on people?
As confissões de uso de armas biológicas aceleraram ambos os lados em direção a um armagedão psicológico, alimentado por sentimentos cada vez maiores de medo e paranoia nos Estados Unidos, provocados na maioria pelo excesso de zelo deste homem.
Are you now, have you ever been a member of the Communist Party?
We're talking about the McCarthy era, and the fact that Americans had shown that they were unable to resist brainwashing reflected the fact that our social institutions were crumbling and the American character was in decay.
I don't think you have any conception of the danger of the Communist Party.
The prisoners of war were said to be brainwashed, and that was the explanation. If they were in fact brainwashed, how was it being done? The CIA and the military attempted to find out, and not only attempted to find out, but attempted to replicate the results using American citizens as guinea pigs.
Americans, they have too many freedoms.
That is another thing you must remember, comrade. For one day it will be your mission to destroy those bourgeois capitalist freedoms.
What you have seen is not entirely fiction. Greater brutality is taking place right now in countries which have been swallowed up by the communist machine. The bright hopes of a free world are founded on the dedication of individual Americans, people who guarantee freedom by standing ready to fight against aggression, against the communist attempts at world enslavement.
A paranoia da Guerra Fria dos anos 50, alimentada pelos acontecimentos mundiais e pelas táticas de McCarthy, de medo vermelho, levou os americanos a acreditar que os comunistas tinham desenvolvido técnicas para transformar seres humanos em robôs.
That concern directly led the CIA hierarchy to authorize a wide-ranging program of human experimentation called MKUltra that involved LSD tests, intensive electroshock experiments, brainwashing experiments.
O objetivo do programa MKUltra era criar armas psicológicas funcionais que contrariassem e ultrapassassem a incapacidade as desenvolvidas pelos comunistas. Entre outras coisas, a investigação explorou a criação do imbatível soro da verdade, de agentes secretos que atuassem como mensageiros subliminares e assassinos programados. À medida que prosseguia a investigação do controle mental, a comunidade de serviços secretos foi subitamente virada do avesso com a descoberta de uma nova substância de grande poder, capaz de alterar a mente.
The thing that really began to come into picture at this time was the discovery of LSD.
Como chefe psiquiátrico da CIA, John Gittinger, foi responsável pela avaliação da eficácia operacional da investigação realizada no MKUltra.
This resulted in eventually there being a considerable effort of doing research on LSD, because this was a completely unknown drug, one which produced results that were completely unpredictable.
I'm feeling perfectly fit at the moment and as sane as I ever am, and I'll take the drug now.
A descoberta do LSD fez com que muitas pessoas tomassem alucinogénios apenas para experimentar. Este interesse chegou até aos membros do Parlamento Britânico.
I am moving at this moment from one time into another time and back again. And I'm not so conscious, Humphrey, of removing myself in space. But I'm extremely conscious of moving in time.
Enquanto o resto do mundo entrava inocentemente no mundo das drogas psicadélicas, Alguns setores da comunidade médica abraçaram o LSD como a nova droga maravilha. Juntaram-se-lhes agentes secretos que começaram eles mesmos a testar possíveis usos para a droga.
All the original acid heads in North America were actually the psychiatrists and the spies. And there's lots of descriptions in the publications I have of psychiatrists talking about their own LSD trips in the 1950s.
I only had it once, and I would never do it again. The first thing that began to happen to me is that the room completely narrowed, and bright lights and all kinds of things. And I suddenly had the feeling like I was running at full speed even though I was sitting still. That very unpleasant experience lasted about a day and a half.
À medida que a CIA continuava os testes com os seus cientistas, as Forças Armadas dos Estados Unidos também ficaram interessadas nos potenciais usos para o LSD, testando-os, inclusive, em soldados americanos.
After receiving a small dose of LSD, they're confused and undisciplined.
The point of all of this was to have weapons that didn't harm. If you wanted to win a war, you could drop a nuclear bomb on a city and that would do it. But it would be better to save lives by disorienting a population. So weapons that didn't harm or kill, such as putting LSD into a water supply, were considered to be more humane.
Esta droga, sem odor ou cheiro, parecia a arma suprema de controle mental. Foi usada como instrumento operacional e todos os agentes deveriam trazê-la consigo. Entre as muitas aplicações possíveis para a droga, estava a possibilidade de ser usada em líderes comunistas como Fidel Castro, na esperança de o desacreditar em público.
The Soviet intelligence was aware of experiments conducted by the United States Central Intelligence Agency, prompting us to report to our superiors in the party apparatus that we need money to do the same, because how could we allow the United States to be ahead of us in any type of military applied research?
There had been reports that came into the CIA that there was literally a mountain of LSD that the Soviets had access to, and it was going to be sold on the open market, and who was going to buy it, and what was it going to do if someone evil got control over it. And so then the stakes got higher. What about unwitting subjects? Because that was the nightmare that American diplomats, American spies, American politicians were going to be subject to this. And then the course sort of went downhill.
À medida que a CIA institucionalizava os seus planos para o MKUltra, necessitava de criar uma via que levasse a droga às pessoas sujeitas a estes testes sem o saberem, bem como às pessoas responsáveis pela gestão da operação.
They pressed into service a federal Bureau of Narcotics official named George Hunter White. He was actually a very high-ranking narcotics official. At one point in line to become head of the whole agency.
White was a cowboy in CIA terms, was a person of action, a person who was daring, a person who was sort of larger than life. Problem was that George White didn't seem to have very much sense of control or responsibility.
Em 1953, White seria colocado a chefiar a maior parte dos testes de campo do MKUltra.
The CIA was particularly interested in finding out at one point during a sexual liaison, a man is more apt to reveal secrets. George White hired prostitutes to pick up men and bring them back to these safe houses.
White would watch behind two-way mirrors while these prostitutes whom he was working with would slip drugs, including LSD, into the drinks of these people who thought they were just there to have a night of pleasure. And indeed, what would happen is the drugs would take effect. The people didn't realize they'd been dosed. Sometimes they'd be, you know, run out of the apartment screaming, and they didn't know what was going on, just sort of fade into the night. So it wasn't exactly a very scientific way to go about doing research.
You could learn nothing scientifically because the men went back out into the street and you never knew what happened to them. And so all you were doing is acting like sophomores in high school and putting at risk a population of men, who, some of whom we must assume died, and others whose lives were ruined.
Enquanto continuavam os testes descontrolados de White em Nova York e São Francisco, outros métodos semelhantes de irresponsabilidade em testes alastravam-se a todo o programa MKUltra. Um dos maiores exemplos de como a CIA não se preocupava com as pessoas sujeitas a testes é a história de Frank Olson.
Frank Olson was an Army biochemist who was working at Fort Detrick in Maryland, which was the headquarters of the Army's biological warfare research and development. And the CIA was also interested in biological warfare. So occasionally what would happen in the early 50s is people from the CIA and the technical service staff would get together with people from the Special Operations Division at Fort Detrick.
There was such a meeting held in November of 1953. Early on in this meeting, there was a cocktail party at which the cocktails were spiked with LSD. And my father was one of the people who drank a cocktail. That evening, after the cocktail hour, my father was scheduled to give some kind of a scientific presentation. And in the course of this presentation, he was told, "You have been drugged with LSD." And my father became disoriented and apparently concerned, to say the least.
Durante os três dias seguintes, a reação de Olson à droga intensificou-se e ele ficou cada vez mais perturbado. Temendo exposição, a CIA decidiu levá-lo da sua família a um médico contratado para o MKUltra, em Nova Iorque, de forma a ser examinado. Foi acompanhado por Robert Lashbrook, um oficial da CIA. Passados seis dias de exames, Olson chamou a família para os informar que regressaria na manhã seguinte. Esse foi o último contacto que a família recebeu dele.
According to the conventional account given by Robert Lashbrook, the two of them had a rather quiet evening in the hotel room, went to bed early, fell asleep, and then sometime shortly after midnight, Lashbrook was wakened by the sound of crashing glass. He looked at the bed next to his in this rather small room, discovered that it was empty, and concluded that my father had gone out the window. The bellboy at the front of the hotel contacted the night manager, Armin Pastore, who then went out to see that my father was lying in the street and in fact was not dead. And Armin Pastore tried to comfort him and tried to speak to him. My father made a few dying sounds and then died essentially in Pastore's arms.
No quarto de hotel, Lashbrook fez uma chamada, não para a polícia, mas para a CIA.
And the call consisted of simply two sentences. The caller said, "Well, he's gone." And the recipient of the call said, "That's too bad." And they both hung up.
No dia seguinte, o seu patrão visitou a casa de Olson com um médico de família.
The two of them came to our house very, very early in the morning. Saturday morning on the 28th of November, wakened my mother and told her that my father had died in what they described as a fall out of a hotel window. And I just remember that my mother was sitting in the corner in shock. And I tried to digest this finding as best I could, which was completely impossible.
Any involvement by the CIA was kept quiet. The entire thing was distanced from the agency, and this was just a man who had committed suicide, and we don't know why, we don't know how, we only know where and that it happened.
Mesmo depois de anos à procura dos factos, estes levaram Olson a acreditar que ainda não sabe a verdadeira história por detrás da morte do pai.
From everything we know about the reckless nature of these experiments, these people were not sentimental about human life, and they would have not hesitated to do whatever they thought was necessary to maintain their research project. If my father's case had become public, it would have derailed a very large program in mind control that continued for many years. And I think that was a risk they couldn't have assumed. And I think we're essentially asked to believe that the CIA got lucky. They did a reckless experiment, something got out of control, but the research subject terminated his own life. And I think it's extremely unlikely that it did occur that way.
A CIA via a morte de Olson como um pequeno revés na experimentação de controle mental, mesmo depois dos próprios advogados da CIA terem concluído que tinham demonstrado um desrespeito completo pela vida humana.
That was a time when the agency could have said and should have said, this stuff is very dangerous. We can't go around giving it to people who don't know about it. We can't take the chance. If we're going to study defensive purposes, we have to find another way, but it can't be this way.
Em vez disso, uma carta de reprimenda foi emitida, o que no fundo significava que nada iria acontecer, e a CIA escolheu em desafio continuar a aumentar a sua investigação sobre o controle mental. Sidney Gottlieb, chefe do projeto MKUltra, elegeu o Allen Memorial Institute no Canadá como local ideal para a próxima e mais agressiva geração de experiências de controle mental. Esta estrutura escura e sombria, também conhecida por Raven's Crag, transformou-se numa casa de horrores psicológica, sob a supervisão de um dos médicos mais famosos do mundo na época, o Dr. Ewan Cameron.
The story of Dr. Ewan Cameron is one of the most tragic, but one of the most clearly visible stories of what happened during the mind control experimentation days.
Usando cidadãos canadianos como cobaias, sem que estes o soubessem, Cameron desenvolveu um novo método que interessou aos investigadores do MKUltra e à comunidade canadiana de serviços secretos. Foi contratado pela CIA e pelo governo canadiano para continuar a explorar um tratamento denominado imposição psíquica.
First, Cameron proposed that they would use intensive electroshock and LSD and other disorienting drugs to, in his terms, de-pattern individuals, basically to wipe the slate clean. Second, using tape-recorded messages, try to program in new behaviors by repeating these messages hundreds of thousands of times while the victim was immobilized with other drugs. And the final phase was to try to wipe the slate clean so that people could not, again, remember what had happened to them but still have the new behavior.
The psychic driving experiments literally reduced the person to a vegetable. One of the group of people was a man called Robert Logie, who lives in Vancouver. He was also a victim of these psychic driving experiments, where tape loops were played countless hours per day, many months in a row.
I heard four words, and it's very hard for me to say. Four words I remember were, you killed your mother.
None of this, of course, was therapeutic. None of it was warranted by the conditions under which the people had gone to the institute. None of it was done with consent, and none of it was done with the awareness of the people that they were experimental guinea pigs in an advanced brainwashing experiment.
Outro dos doentes de Cameron, que sofreu meses de tortura, foi Linda MacDonald.
I think there were about 80 of us. We discovered that these 80 people were just ordinary, everyday people. It could have been you, it could have been me, it was me. It could have been anybody who just walked through the doors of the Allen Memorial on the wrong day at the wrong time when Dr. Cameron needed another schizophrenic for his fun little stuff upstairs.
Linda MacDonald started off as a pretty much normal person. She basically came into the hospital as a mother with many young children who was a little overwhelmed and depressed for just routine psychiatric treatment.
And 3 weeks after I was there, I was shipped up to the sleep ward. And I came out of there vegetable 5 months later.
By the time someone was in the sleep room, the ability of that individual to remember or describe what happened to them was very limited. So the descriptions that there are from nurses and from other people who worked at the facility, and their descriptions are, to quote one, like something out of Dante's Inferno.
Dentro deste inferno, os doentes eram sujeitos a terapia de choque, que ia muito para além das linhas de orientação profissional que ditavam um máximo de 4 a 8 tratamentos.
I received a total of 109 electroconvulsive shock treatments. In less than 5 weeks, I had 86 straight comatose days where I was completely out of it. The purpose for all of this was to wipe from my memory, to take a life, to wipe it completely clean. So I would not have a memory ever. When I came out of the treatment and they had decided that my memory was wiped sufficiently. I didn't know who I was. I was a baby. They had to toilet train me, and they had to teach me to walk and talk and feed myself.
She has absolutely zero direct memory of her life before age 25. Now, it doesn't take long to figure out why the CIA or other intelligence agencies would be interested in such research.
Well, if Cameron can get it to work for a psychiatric patient, well, then they can use the same thing to deprogram somebody and put them back together for a brainwashing scenario.
Só muitos anos mais tarde, depois de divórcio complicado e a perda dolorosa da custódia dos filhos, é que Linda MacDonald viria a saber dos objetivos secretos por detrás do tratamento que recebera.
This big headline saying Dr. Cameron, CIA, brainwashing experiments, and I stopped breathing for a minute. You could have knocked me over. I knew Dr. Cameron was my doctor. I knew I had been at the Allen Memorial. But up until that moment, I believed, because that's what I was told, that the doctor had fixed me, had done to me great things, and I was lucky that he had been my doctor. So I couldn't not read the article, and as I read it, I was just horrified.
The idea that one goes and unwittingly tests substances that we don't know very much about on people that don't have access to medical treatment, they're not followed up, they're treated contemptibly, that was not an ethical treatment then, and it's not ethical treatment now.
My participation in it was in terms of trying to evaluate the behavior that was described. I don't think I can add anything that hasn't already been. Frankly, it's an area I don't like to talk about. It's not that I don't like to talk about it. You can tell from the way I'm reacting to this that this is an uncomfortable period for me to reflect on at this particular time. It didn't worry me at the time. Now I wonder why it didn't.
Justiça, como a conhecemos, não veio rapidamente para as vítimas das experiências de Cameron. Jim Turner foi dos advogados que passou anos a lutar contra os governos americano e canadiano em seu nome.
Each of my clients who had already been victimized by the CIA was compelled under a court order to submit to a psychiatric evaluation and interview by CIA finance psychiatrist that was tape recorded. Now, tape recording doesn't sound like a big deal, but you got to remember, these are people who had been subjected to psychic driving. So on the eve of their trial, when they're going to have to tell their story, you're showing up with the tape recorder with the psychiatrist. That is another, not so subtle form of intimidation in my view.
It took a long, long time with the government playing games and saying they didn't want to take any responsibility. It wasn't their fault. They didn't know what they were doing. That's what was done in those days, on and on and on. I guess that's one of the reasons that they took as long as they did to settle, because they just wore us out. They sure wore me out anyway. I look back at my life and it's sad, because I can imagine what it would have been like if that hadn't happened. I try not to think of it that way, though, because it doesn't get me anywhere. But it's an empty place.
No início da década de 70, informações respeitantes às atrocidades de controlo mental efetuadas pela CIA começaram a vir a público. Uma investigação foi iniciada e resultou na criação de uma comissão presidencial e duas do Senado.
And my feeling now is that the CIA had overall powers that put them in a different situation than other people.
Os americanos estavam em choque.
I am terribly upset that the system is such that what happened could happen.
Contudo, a sua busca por respostas em breve cairia por terra quando os investigadores souberam que o Dr. Sidney Gottlieb tinha destruído grande parte dos documentos relacionados com o programa MKUltra. Era agora impossível aos americanos descobrirem a verdade sobre o que tinha a CIA descoberto com a pesquisa de controle mental. Oficialmente, a posição da CIA é que 30 anos de experimentação agressiva tinham alcançado resultados pouco produtivos ou mesmo nulos.
There's been a lot of
let's say, laboratory nonsense, both by the Russians and people all over, thinking that they have to do very elaborate things like have flashing lights, that they have to immerse people in hot water tanks and so on. But when all is said and done, person-to-person social and psychological manipulations are far more effective, they're cheaper, and they accomplish what the mind control people want.
As mais produtivas são estas técnicas de coação, bem testadas nos anos 40 e 50, e não um método altamente científico que se tornou o legado do programa MKUltra da CIA. Essas técnicas acabariam por colocar a todos em risco, porque aquilo que a CIA não percebeu é que, durante anos, elas tinham chegado ao setor privado, onde estavam a ser aperfeiçoadas e usadas por grupos dissidentes e extremistas. A prova de que este cenário era real pode ser vista no caso Patty Hearst. A herdeira do Império de Publicações Hearst foi raptada e convertida numa criminosa comum por um grupo de captores diabólicos que tinham grandes conhecimentos de técnicas de controle mental.
This is the film that the jury saw today. Note especially the figure at the upper left, Donald DeFries, also known as Sin Q, leader of the so-called Symbionese Liberation Army. Miss Hearst is at the upper right.
Basically, she was captured from where she was living in Berkeley, California. She was kept in a closet for many weeks in a row, and many different mind control methods and techniques, similar to those studied in MKUltra, were used on her.
For 60 days and nights, she was subjected to a degree of torture that went considerably beyond Cardinal Manzetti's, including physical pain, rape, constant threats of death. She was blindfolded the whole time and held in a tiny closet. And then a few days later, they take her into a bank. Here's Sin Q standing behind her with an M16 pointing at her back, and she makes her little speech. I am Tanya, Patricia Hearst, just in case you didn't know, and these are the forces of liberation or whatever. And then she forgot the rest. And then when they started shooting, she almost lost it because she thought they were shooting at her because she had not given her spiel right. In fact, they shot a couple people who came into the bank. They took $9,000 out of that bank. And the next day or two, the Attorney General of the United States says, we now know Patricia Hearst is a common criminal. This is all over the papers. They show it to her. They say, no, your bridges are burned. You stay with us. The FBI even sees you, they'll shoot you down dead.
Patty Hearst told me that she felt the Symbionese Liberation Army was a real army, you know, like the U.S. Army. They told her they'd taken over the United States, that they'd captured, you know, everybody in the media. She was unaware, she told me, that there were only 9 in the Symbionese Liberation Army because they totally controlled what she knew.
She was suffering so much from what we would now call a post-traumatic stress disorder that she was more or less helpless in the hands of her captors. She was a victim of mind control from beginning to end.
Para o mundo, a história de Patty Hearst veio a simbolizar vulnerabilidade. Se Patty estava em risco, todos nós estamos. Ainda mais assustador é o facto do controle potencial oferecido por estas técnicas refinadas de coação parecer ilimitado.
I think it's possible to brainwash, manipulate, coerce people to do just about anything, and we see this demonstrated in military training or in the kind of conditioning that people go through when they get involved in cults, and they do things that are certainly way outside of the normal parameters of what they would consider moral.
Em nenhum lugar foi este facto mais evidente do que num pequeno país sul-americano, a Guiana, no inverno de 1978. O local chamava-se Johnstown. À superfície parecia ser uma comunidade de famílias etnicamente diferentes reunidas pelo reverendo Jim Jones para que vivessem o sonho de uma sociedade racialmente harmoniosa.
This reporter spoke to many Jonestown people. They all insisted that it was a peaceful and productive place in which to live.
Are you happy here?
Oh, I should say I am. I've never been any happier in my life.
Mesmo com a aparência de normalidade, chegavam aos Estados Unidos relatórios de abusos sexuais, tortura e privação de liberdade dos membros dessa comunidade. Leo Ryan, congressista de São Francisco, voou para a Guiana para investigar estes relatórios.
Very glad to be here. This is a congressional inquiry. I think that all of you know that I'm here to find out more about questions that have been raised about your operation here. But I can tell you right now that from the few conversations I've had with some of the folks here already this evening, that whatever the comments are, there are some people here who believe that this is the best thing that ever happened to them in their whole life.
Os eventos do dia seguinte chocariam o mundo.
This is what Jonestown looked like yesterday, when a group of American airmen arrived there. The airmen wandered about at first, so stunned by what they saw that they were unable to begin identifying and removing the bodies.
Os factos eram inacreditáveis. O congressista Ryan e vários membros do seu partido foram atacados e assassinados. Centenas de pessoas mortas através da ingestão voluntária de cianeto. O mundo questionava-se como podia isto ter acontecido.
The methods that Jim Jones used in his cult, the People's Temple, are definitely classical mind control techniques. And according to a book by Michael Myers, which is called Was Jonestown a CIA Medical Experiment, his documentation leads him to conclude that actually Jonestown was run by the CIA. Prior to being Jonestown in the deep jungles of British Guiana, that site was actually under control of what was called the Shalom Project. This was a CIA program for training black mercenaries for warfare in Angola.
O poder de controle de um homem e o abuso desse poder mostrou ao mundo a chegada do culto moderno, um predador que se move silenciosamente entre a população e todos podemos ser um alvo potencial.
The big problem with cults in our society is that the victims appear to be willing. They're drawn in, seeking self-improvement or a desire to do good things, and are swiftly embodied in a context that affects their thinking and behavior more and more, getting them to do things that they would never do before, whether it be Jonestown, whether it be Waco, whether it be the Tokyo subway system.
Bombistas suicidas, assassinos em série, suicídios em massa. Tudo isto e ainda outros comportamentos extremistas são provas horrendas da evolução do controle mental.
If you have groups like cults which are organized and manipulate information, then you have potential exploitation of an extraordinary degree. The lesson to be learned is that that possibility is always there and it may be for anybody.
Tendo em conta o passado repleto de tantas vidas dilaceradas e um rasto de tortura mental, o desafio deste novo milénio será aprender a proteger-nos do controle mental.
Somehow, the average citizen thinks that his or her mind could never be manipulated. And yet every day we're manipulated by each other, we're manipulated by advertising. 1,000 things impact and manipulate us in different ways.
We're bombarded with messages from the media, the radio, the television, and from newspapers that shape our perceptions of the world.
Este condicionalismo incessante, mas subtil, pode ser desenvolvido mesmo sem darmos por isso.
Watching television is a trance-like experience. You forget about the carpet, the curtains, and that you're sitting in a room, and you engage your experience directly into the television screen, so that whatever happens on the screen seems really real. You know, you suspend belief in reality. If you don't take responsibility for what goes into your mind, somebody else will. Cult leaders, politicians, advertisers will all seek to implant their message in your mind, whether it's for your good or not.
The greatest battle of the 21st century will be a battle of the mind. And there are people who have power who want more power, and they do not want the public to know about mind control, its existence, or how it's implemented.
There is a body of information being used by government to control the way people think and act, and experiments are systematically designed to increase government's knowledge about that. This is the most threatening part of being a citizen in a democracy. When your government can manipulate how you vote and how you think, you no longer live in a democracy.
Locução: Alberto Ramos, Ideias e Letras.